All right, yes, it's that time again to talk about some music, and specifically on tape, but not all music, and that's what I'm going to start off with. Since the last time I did this, I got quite a few of these here. Some are soundtracks. Again, I'm really kind of want to collect those, or ones I'm interested in. I explained it before, but one or two interesting things here, especially when I get to the singular tapes. But the first thing I want to show is something I got a little while ago, and it's not music, but I actually didn't expect to find something like this. Much less in really good shape and complete, but hey, there you go. And I couldn't turn it down for really not much of anything at all, and I've been listening to them a lot. It's pretty cool. So here we go. This is, sorry about the road noise. The computer needs ventilation, so I have to have the windows open. Anyway, so as you can see here, quite a few of these, but I'll get into them more in a second. This is the radio play recordings of New Adventures of Sherlock Holmes. Well, this is Volume 2 anyway. Volume 1 was not there. And, yeah, 16 adventures. Two on each side, of course, obviously. And 60 minutes on each tape, so it's quite a many hours of entertainment. If I hold it still here, you can pause it and read that yourself. I can't remember the other guy's name, but Basil Rathbone and such. This all started in, I think the late 40s, was 1947 or something like that, and it went into the 60s, but then they replaced who Watson and Sherlock Holmes was. I know some of these, and I've heard some of these in the past, but it's pretty cool to just, have these in some kind of physical form. You can actually, I'll put it in the description, why not? There's a link to, there's a site that's dedicated to old radio recording stuff like this, and all these are on there, and many more I don't have, so, whatever. But I still think it's cool to have these on tape. I can't complain. I've been listening to them a lot. And as you can see, 60 minutes on each one. So that's pretty cool. There's some Christmas ones in here. Some of these I actually do know by name, so there's that. I can't get them out. Hold on. We'll go look through these real quick and see what ones there are. I don't know how loud the road noise is being picked up on that, but hey, whatever. So this one's the Noble Bachelor and the Thor Bridge. Actually, one thing with these I gotta complain with is I wish it said the dates so you knew what order they go in. So I've just been listening to them however I want to. I'm not gonna take every one out, but you can see what it looks like here. And on the tape itself, it shows the date for when this release anyway happened, which was 1991. Now, they're old recordings, so forget about that they're on tape. The tapes are perfectly fine. There's a lot of pops and scratches from the records or whatever they were taken from the source material, so there's that. But it's old radio play stuff. It's like that Flash Gordon record I have. It's much the same, besides the record itself. But they're also old recordings, so you have to take that into account. They're really not that bad. And actually, I've been listening to them without any kind of noise reduction. Seems to be better. I'm not a big fan of noise reduction on the Denon I have anyway. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just, I think I've kind of referred to this before in the last one. B is okay, it's pretty much the one to use for anything. C is way too aggressive, and even then, sometimes it's just muddles things. I don't know. So, maybe it's just me, but I think it's better without it sometimes. Anyway, and they all have the same cover, they all pretty much look the same. But this one has the Blanched Soldier and the Rigate Squires. And again, this one here. Most of these have the original two guys. Oh, yeah, wait a minute, my bad. I forgot on this side it actually says the names. I'm bad with names. Basil Rathbone, Nigel Bruce, and John Stanley. These two guys, Sherlock Holmes and Watson, they're in most of these here, but then it goes into the later ones where they replace them. But not only that, they also changed kind of the format and how it works. I like those two, but I preferred the original guys. They just seemed much better. I'm a big fan of Sherlock Holmes. I've read quite a few of the books in the past. I don't have any anymore. The Great Gandolfo, I like that one a lot. I think this is the one where they changed over to the other people. And the Gunpowder Plot. There's one of the Christmas ones then. The Missing Heiress and the Sussex Vampire. That's the one. That's one of my favorite ones. That's one of the ones I knew when I saw it. I wish I could have got Volume 1 as well. I'm not going to go out of my way to get it, but I wasn't expecting to see this. It was with a bunch of 8-track tapes. All the other tapes I'm going to show, by the way, come from the same place where I found this, except for one. And that's the only one that wasn't 50 cents as well. This was 50 cents for each one, so they'll hold together. I can't complain for that, especially the condition they're in. The Retired Colorman, which was a weird one to me, I admit. And The Night Before Christmas. There's two Christmas ones here. If I remember right, this is the one I like more personally. I don't know if you're interested. Yeah, I already looked at that one. doesn't really matter because, like I said, no way to know what order they were really supposed to go in. The Copper Beaches and the Missing Bloodstains. That's another one I like a lot. I think that's the one with the crazy old guy. Yeah, he was trying to hide the blood and didn't really work out. The Accidental Murderess. That one's pretty good, too. The Manor House Case. I like that one a lot. And I think this is the one that's got the other Christmas one on it. Yep, The Christmas Bride, which was a little odd. I think I've heard that one before, but maybe not. I don't know. And The Wooden Claw, which is an interesting one. Really, they're all good, like I said, even when they change over to the other guys. But I do definitely prefer the original people. It's just like the whole style of it changed. They also had another cool thing is they had the old promotional things in here, which is kind of cool. I definitely suggest listening to them if you like the kind of... Well, if you like listening to... It's not like an audiobook, but... It's, I don't know how to explain it. There's a certain appeal, anyway, personally, to me, I have with this old radio play stuff, and that's why I had to go for this, besides, you know, good shape, like I said, and it's complete. And it was cheap. It's something very interesting about it that we kind of lost. We don't have much of anymore. I guess that's kind of why I like podcasts, in a way. Not just game ones, but they talk about things, they tell stories, because it reminds me of this kind of stuff. I wouldn't mind finding more of it if I can. Alright, now we're going to get into the actual music. Everything else is music. And I want to start with another thing, which I got at the same place, but further back. I'm trying to go in order. All the rest is what I got recently, in the same day even. Alright, so here's one I don't have a ton I can say about, but there is some things I want to explain. I like Sheena Easton a good amount, but I never had like a full album, but now I do. I didn't want to dig it out, but actually on 45, I have a thing that's part of this. It's a very good album. I like it a lot. A Private Heaven. Now, this is when she was trying to transition, so to speak, out of the... I can't remember what the exact quote was, but she didn't want to be seen as a kind of a, like, sexy, stereotypical kind of pop star type person. So that's what this album was trying to transition out of, but I don't know. It's very 80s sounding. I love it. But it's definitely a good one, and I can't complain with it. It's perfect shape, too, so hey, there you go. But this is the one I came by, and that's the songs that are on it. There's two songs I want to talk about here, not that no one hasn't done this before, probably might know already. Autofocus, work. There you go. Anyway, there's two songs in here that were seen as controversial, one more than the other, and they're both really good songs. And one is Swear, right here, which I really like a lot the way it sounds, although sometimes I swear she's saying sweat. Where's the other ones? The one that was the most, got the most flack? Sugar Walls. Now, the thing that you'll find most interesting here, if you don't already know, is it's a song that Prince wrote for her. And it sounds very much like a Prince song, both in the lyrics and just the way the music itself sounds. The controversy here, if you can't figure it out, is that it's seen as, although it was denied, that it's referring to, well, vagina. But, I don't know. You listen to the lyrics and you can kind of see that, but it's just a good song. Whether or not it's code for anything or not, that's what the actual tape looks like, if you've never seen one before. 1984, and it's in perfect shape. I just want to point that out. And I don't know if you want to see the thing on the inside. If I hold it still enough, you should be able to read it, even with YouTube's junking up with the video as it does. Okay, so there's that one. Now, we're going to get into the most recent stuff, and do I want to do that? Yeah, I'll do this one first. This is the most interesting one, and I kind of wanted it just because of what it is. This is also the one that cost not 50 cents, it was a dollar. I tried to go lower, but hey, whatever. It is full songs on here, which I wasn't sure about at first. Person didn't let me try it like some do for others. This is something, as much as I know about car stuff, and especially when it comes to Ford, I didn't actually know about, and, well, I just like having it because it's kind of a double thing. It's a cool oddity, but it's also like an automotive collectible, quote-unquote, and it's in very good shape. Somehow I never knew about this. I don't know. I thought it was a dealer-only thing, but apparently they just give it to you. But, well, I might as well show up before I keep going on about it. This was a surprise to find. The other tape I was looking at with the same person had was Rick James' Greatest Hits, and it was all fucked up. I don't know. It's a shame. I really wanted that. But anyway, this is an audio system demonstration tape, which when I read that, I thought it meant dealer-only. But whatever. Music selections from CBS Records Library. And wait until you see what I show you what songs are in here, especially the first one, which is what got my attention. Ford Audio Systems, JBL. Yes, it's duplicated in real time. It's actually very high quality tape, too, given it's car company as big as Ford is. They should be able to afford a good metal tape. Anyway, basically what this was is they gave it to you if you chose the option to upgrade whatever the standard stuff was in your car. I don't know the exact models. Crematoria, I'm sure, was one. But, they gave this to you as just like a way you could test out and try out. Well, it actually kind of explains itself. I'll show you in a minute. But if you went with the option for the higher-end JBL sound system, they would give you this. They don't really do that these days, of course. But again, sorry for the background noise. I got to do what I got to do. I'm talk loud. Fortunately, I should cover over it. But it, a little bit different these days, how they go about things. But back then, though, they would give you something like this. And it's from 1988. Before I forget to mention that. Anyway, so this is what the other one looks like. I'll just take it out. We're going to spend a little time on this one, I admit. Alright, so this is what it actually looks like. And let's get into what the songs are on this, because that's what got my interest. It actually has the theme from Raiders of the Lost Ark on here, which makes a little bit of sense. They did do a pretty good variety, I think, of what kind of music's on here. And there is a classical song. It's the last one on the second side. So they got a good variety on here, I think. Ford has good taste. There's one or two songs I wasn't so sure about, and I kind of wish it said who the artists were on here, because I couldn't figure it out, and then I looked in the thing and it tells you. One that did surprise me is, because I was expecting, because he's the one that's most famous for it, is George on My Mind here is not the Ray Charles version, but that's the Willie Nelson one. Anyway, but yeah, there's even a Toto song on here, Rosanna, which I was having a hard time trying to remember that was one of theirs. Send the Clowns, a Barbra Streisand song. It's 1988, so you gotta figure out who was popular and so on and so forth at the time, and Raiders of the Lost Ark was fairly recent still. To a degree. And here's what's on the other side. Kari was one I didn't know by name. Matador and Rhapsody in Blue is your classical song. Let's look at the actual thing here. And again, I'll try and hold it still enough so you can read it. Actually, maybe I might. I'm not sure if I'm going to do it. I'm saying this as I'm recording it, of course. But maybe I'll take a still shot and I'll superimpose it on the screen. You can pause that with the still camera. But here's what the songs are and the artist. And it even tells you how long they are, which is nice. So you should be able to read that, I think, I'm holding it still enough. And here's what I was trying to explain myself. It didn't explicitly say if it was for dealers only, which I thought it might have been. But I don't know, I just find this really interesting, and I had to have it. It's a kind of a cool oddity. All right, I spent a little too much time on this now. Sorry. Fortunately, the music I have, I can actually burn through more. But as I said, these are the full songs, so that's pretty cool. All right, let's get into these next. Now, all these are the same place where I got the Sherlock Holmes things, which is a treasure trove for cassette tapes. They're all 50 cents, and every time I go there, there's more and more there all the time. Let me try them all out. It's great. I spent a lot of time the other day testing all these out. Now, I know they're all from one person. That's how I got my James Bond tapes. It was pretty much a collection from one person. They took good care of them. Same with these. I've never been, like, huge into... I've mentioned this before, and I'm not counting, like, since Disney Wars, definitely. I'm not huge on that. But, you know, how they handle Marvel, I like, and all. Which I actually saw Spider-Man Far From Home the other day because I had to kill time. I liked it, just to throw that in. But anyway, I'm missing kind of like Disney stuff when it comes to my soundtrack collecting. So, spoiler, you already know what I'm going to show. And there was quite a few there. I went with the ones that interest me, but also the ones that were in good shape. Obviously, why the hell would I go with ones that are screwed up? And, well, let's just go with this one first because it's standalone. Beauty and the Beast, which actually, again, another, this surprised me. I could have sworn it came out a little later than 1991, but now apparently it's 1991. I like Lion King the most when it comes to the anime stuff, but I really did like Beauty and the Beast. Now, here's the thing I actually wanted to say before I kind of cut my own self off. While I've never been huge on Disney either way, I do like the animated stuff they did better, even though my favorite Disney movie is the first Tron, which I don't have the soundtrack for. I can't come buy it. I guess I'm going to have to get it specifically on eBay. Anyway, I don't know if I'll get it on tape, if it even came out on tape. Anyway, one of the things I've always really liked with Disney is the music and their stuff. It's fantastic. So, you know, might not be a kid anymore, but I still like listening to music, and that's kind of why I was willing to go for this, and I was kind of missing anything Disney when it comes to my soundtrack stuff. And for 50 cents, I can't complain, and it's in really good shape. And when it comes to, like, the anime movie stuff and the music, you can't really go wrong with Beauty and the Beast. I have Lion King Special Edition I finally got recently on CD, so, you know, whatever. That's the one I've been specifically trying to get. Anyway, so yeah, Beauty and the Beast, and for some reason it's in a kind of side thing, which I got this much less than it goes for on eBay. Also better shape than anything I saw on eBay, just kicks looking at it. Now, this is something else, maybe pointless and wasting time, but I want to point out, I just find it's kind of interesting. Disney didn't always have their own record thing they had to put their music out on, and at one point they did this, and I don't know, I just kind of like the logos. Mickey is a conductor. It's pretty cool. Gives me Fantasia vibes, which I actually did get a Fantasia. It was only one part of the soundtrack, but it was screwed up. Eh, what can you do? Anyway, so yeah, Beauty and the Beast, you know the songs, of course. I'm pretty sure. It's all there, and it's in good shape. not the only time we're going to see some Beauty and the Beast stuff.
Spoiler for what's about to happen in a second. Let's get this out of the way.
Very professional here with all that road noise, but I can't do nothing about it. Alright, so this is... I'm not so sure. I remember in the past these, and as far as I can remember, I think there's only two. So I'm going to say I have the full set. If I'm wrong, correct me. This is something else I can't remember, even though as good as my memory is. I remember these back when they were brand new, and I could have sworn they were demonstrably expensive. Like, oddly more than what, for what they are, they should be. But then again, it's Disney. Anyway, so, very good music on both of these, and they came out, and I want to make sure before I say it. Hold on. 1995. Yeah, so certain things aren't here. So there's nothing from Tarzan, which I actually like a lot, by the way. And I also like Pocahontas, although I do understand the problems with it and the complaints and blah, blah, blah. I like the music in it. So they're not on here. But you got Beauty and the Beast. You got a lot of the old stuff on here, too, which I'll admit, again, because I'm not massive into Disney, I actually don't know what some of the older stuff is from. I never saw Jungle Book, I admit, but I know the songs from it, which, you know, Bare Necessities is on here. I think there's some others, but that's the one I know by name, and I can recognize it without doubt. We'll get into what the songs are on here anyway. But one side is kind of the more recent stuff, and the other side is the older stuff. That's pretty much how they did it. So here's volume one here. Again, I don't know if there's a third. I don't think there is. As if this doesn't take long enough. Thanks, Semi. Anyway, so here's side one for this one. 60 years of musical magic. Which maybe I might use that as the subtitle. Musical magic. Anyway, so you can see it starts off with A Whole New World from Aladdin. Which I wouldn't mind getting the whole soundtrack for that one. I think I saw it there, I'm not sure. Anyway, if I hold this still enough, maybe it'll actually focus and you can read what the hell the damn songs are. As I said, I know most but between the two of them, but there's plenty I don't know. I've still never seen Mary Poppins, believe it or not, but I know the music from it. I really like it a lot, that's why I want to see it. They did a good job sticking a lot of songs in here. It helps that many of them are short. Autofocus really doesn't want to work right now. That's an interesting one right there, by the way, I want to point out. Minnie's Yoo-Hoo, not one I've heard before. Alright, I don't want to dwell on this because we're already taking a long time. Alright, so here's Volume 2. Actually, really, even if there is another one, I just like that I was able to get both of these and they're in good shape. I'm just saying. Marker on that for some reason. Alright, so here we go with Side 1. I also wanted to listen to all the tapes I got before I talked about it so I can say things. Oh, this one's focusing better. It likes blue better than that color. And this one starts off with Beauty and the Beast. See, I told you to see more. Then there's more Lion King there, Part of Your World, Little Mermaid. And there's Bare Necessities. Alright, and of between the two of these and either side, this one, side two on this tape, probably has the most I don't know. Oh, come on, autofocus, work with me. Yes, the Tiki 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 Room. Love that song. It's very, very catchy. And you gotta go all the way practically to the end to hear the one from Sleeping Beauty. Hi-ho! Every time I hear that, I always think of that one part in Gremlins. And speaking of songs I have no freaking idea about, the very last one, Who's Afraid of the Big Bad Wolf? I think I probably have heard it before, but hell if I can recognize it. And where is it? I think it's on this one? Yeah, there it is. The Mickey Mouse Club March. Of course, every time I hear that, I think of Full Metal Jacket. What can I say? Again, I just always really like their music, even the ones I'm not familiar with, I like still. It seems like to me, even though with the years when this came out, they kind of left some stuff out, unless I can't recognize it, like that The Aristocrats. I can never remember the damn name of that movie, and I just did. There's Pinocchio on here, but there's some things it seems missing. I mean, they wouldn't put Briar Rabbit on here. Why would they? They don't like admitting that it even exists. All right, we have four more to go, or I have four more to go, and you might be a little surprised by, well, three of these, but I'll explain why, and it probably shouldn't be that surprising if you have seen previous videos like this I've done and I've shown. It shouldn't be surprising, but we're going to do this one first because it's not like those. Yes, I actually really like that I was able to get this one. It's in great shape. Dolly Parton, yes. And also, side one starts with my favorite song of hers, which is 9 to 5, which is from a movie which I still haven't seen, but I would like to because I like the song a lot. And, well, Deadpool 2 helps popularize it even more, but whatever. I've never been huge on Dolly Parton. To me, she's done a lot of stuff. She's done a lot of things. She had her own theme park, Dolly World. But anyway, to me, it was always her music, and this is really good music on here, I gotta say. Really like a lot. There's a Christmas song on here, too, which I don't think I've heard of hers before, or I just don't remember it. It's pretty good. odd lyrics, I think. Bump the camera, sorry. Applejack. I Will Always Love You. Now, here's something I want to point out, maybe you don't know. Of course, many, and I mean many, know Whitney Houston did that mainly for the movie The Bodyguard. And I like that version a lot, too. I kind of prefer it in a way, but it's actually Dolly Parton who wrote it and did it originally. Which, by the way, again, bringing up Spider-Man Far From Home, they play the Whitney Houston version in the beginning for the intro when it's showing the Marvel thing, which caught me off guard. And then it plays Vacation by the Buggles. Is it that who did it? I can't remember. Bangles? It's one of them, I'm pretty sure, in the credits. Anyway, yeah, Dolly Parton wrote that song, and, well, just to point that out. And this looks just like the Sheena Easton one, pretty much, except for it's RCA this time. But there you go. Applejack is an interesting song. Not one I really remember, but I like it. Okay, now let's go into something really old. Glenn Miller. Yep. Might seem a little odd, but I really do like this stuff. I really do like the old stuff like this. And Glenn Miller, well, if you know about him, you know it's some really good shit. I have one or two 45s of his stuff on here, and Tuxedo Junction and Moonlight Serenade, which is the name of the album, it's also the song. I have those on one of them, but they're not in the best of shape, so that's kind of also why I wanted to get this. And the tape, well, sounds better than what that is, because it's all rough. Always like seeing the RCA Victor dog. Anyway, I'll just show you what the tape itself looks like, because why not? You get a better image of the dog. Not a very long one, but they're short songs, and originally recorded prior to 1972. Thanks for not telling me exactly what year, but this release came out in 1992, so at least that's for certain. Yeah, can't complain with this at all. Like that I got that. There's actually a lot of classical music there, which about to get into some more, but it's not all in the best of shape and not all of it I really want. It all depends who it is. Like, there was a Tchaikovsky thing there, but it was missing really anything I'd really want specifically. All right, which one am I going to show for some? Okay, I'll do this one first. Actually, I tested it, but I didn't do enough. I thought it was, like, just the music, but none of the actual stuff. I don't want to dwell on this, but maybe I should mention this, because maybe you might think it's weird, because, you know, maybe I'm not the kind of demographic, or I'm not old enough for it. I'm not huge on it, but honestly, I do actually like opera a decent amount. It all depends what it is from, what it's for, and all that kind of stuff, and the songs themselves. But, you know, I saw this, I tested it out, I looked at what was on it, and I couldn't really turn it down. I really liked it, and there's some good stuff on here if you're into this, like I am. Barbara Seville is one of my favorite. I love that. Although, not Figaro. Figaro's Aria, that's not on here. And, what's that other one? I can't remember what it's called right now. Sorry, I'm trying to do this on the fly. Compared to the next one I'm about to show, this is a lot easier to read what the titles are. Alright, here's the way I can explain it. The one I'm thinking, this also applies for the next tape. The one that's kind of missing on here, that I really, really, really like a lot, it's one of my favorites. If you like Star Trek Voyager and you saw it, the one where the Doctor is singing opera and he's kind of daydreaming and he has to inject Tuvok in the ass because he's going through the Ponfar thing. The song he's singing, that one, is missing from here and the next thing I'm about to show you, which kind of really hurts because I love that one. I want to get it on something. I don't even have it on 45 on its own. I love that song. I could listen to it on loop forever. Maybe not forever, but still. I like it a lot. Anyway, so here's what's on side two. Barbara Seville again there. It's got some Bizet on here. Really nice. Yeah, again, can't complain with this one at all. Especially, it's in really good shape. And last tape, fortunately, because this is going on a little too long. My goal was 20 minutes, but I already fucked that up. Sorry. Just know how I am by now. And this is another one I'm actually really happy to get. Not maybe the specific thing, but it's good enough. It's basically like greatest hits. Again, another thing, given what I just said about the opera one, you shouldn't be surprised. But this is a specific person I've always really liked since I was a little kid. I'm not joking. I've watched DVD like concerts he's done. More than one. Someone was like, you like him. You want to watch these? Hell yeah. He also has some other people with him. I like the Free Tenors a lot, but he's my favorite. So you already know who I'm talking about, probably. Yep, Luciano Pavarotti. Here's another example I have, which really, really hurts. I love his version of Ave Maria, which it's on here. It says it on the front. But I couldn't find it when I was reading the actual like thing, because, well, look how they did it. It's a little confusing. I know a few words in Italian, but not enough. Anyway, I have on 45 a thing of his where one side's, I can't remember what it is right now, but the other one's Ave Maria, which I like that song a lot. A lot of people have done it. I really like his version a lot, and that's the side that's fucked up, so yay me. I got it for nothing, so I can't complain. Paid 50 cents for this, and it's actually in good shape. So yeah, I might as well show you what the thing looks like. Very nice and clean and good shape. A little jingly, but some of them are like that. I'll hold this really still, and maybe you can make it out better than I can. But really good stuff on here. Can't complain. Was listening to it last night, and well, yeah, there you go. I finally have some kind of thing that's more than two songs and one side's not all fucked up for Pavarotti, which is what I've been wanting. So I can't complain with that at all. So there you go. That's the tapes I've gotten most recently. I took a break from getting them for a while, as I said the last time I did this, but yeah. Don't know when the next time I'll be doing one of these, because again, it's not like a for certain thing, but you know, I'll probably get enough again. I'll do a thing on. I would like to do these quicker, but you know, it's like any of those things when you're into something a lot, you're going to go on about it a lot and you want to talk about it that way. So I'm like this with games. I'm like this with music, of course. So again, I hope you weren't bored. Maybe you found this interesting. Maybe you learned a little something. I don't know. And listen to Sugar Walls and decide yourself if it's actually got a hidden meaning or not. It's just a really good song. I stand by that. Anyway, I'll see you later.